can't be that bad.
That's what everyone says before they watch it. That's what everyone says before
Josh
they watch
it. He watched the first 10 minutes of it, and he is now scarred.
Yeah. So is every fucking other person that watched Boku no Pico.
Okay, him, Josh, Justin's ex-girlfriend, Jake, and Jake's current girlfriend were in a group Facebook group chat.
Okay.
And Jake was starting to get into anime. And he's
what
like,
should I watch?
Okay. And Justin was like, "Don't do that." And Josh was like, "It's a really good anime, and
it's very well animated."
Justin was like, "It's scary, Jake," and he's like, "Well," Josh tried to pull it off. He was like, "It is kind of a horror genre."
Yeah, it's pretty terrifying, scarring.
Have you seen it?
God, no. But I've watched reactions to it. And I'm like, I'm never watching this. Ever. It's like the whole two girls, one cup thing. You watch it. Have fun with that. I'm never watching it. I don't need that in my life. I don't need that image. I don't need those images. I mean, I already got enough like context clues from people's reactions to piece together what happened. And I'm like, no, I don't think I want that. I don't think I like that.
It made you think that it's a girl. It's not a girl.
It's not a girl. It's a little boy. It's all about little boys. And that's the weirdest thing. It's the weirdest part. And it's the creepiest part. Alright. You ready? You want to do some vocal exercises? Because you'll be talking so much.
Me, me, me. No, I kind of just sit here and I'm just like... Mm-hmm,
yeah, you're just watching.
Mm-hmm.
Like beautiful reading ability.
Eyes.
What'd you do?
I don't know. I think some of this fuzzy stuff's getting in my eyes.
Did you shoot your eye out?
Oh man, don't do that.
You look just like him. You really do. You really look like the kid. Now stick your tongue on a frozen pole.
I don't see no frozen pole.
You look at Mike. Don't do it.
Alright.
Welcome! Longest intro ever. No, not cutting it all out. Welcome!
Hey, everyone!
To part 2 of Higurashi Chapter 2.
It's only part 2?
What the fuck do you think? Where have you been?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was counting all the previous ones that we've done.
Oh, god damn.
Joey.
I'm sorry. Throw me for a loop. You are stupid. Load.
Hey.
Hi, Joey. Are you stuck, man?
Maybe. We already went all over the tips and...
The tip. Continuing. Okay, shoving the mouse over here. Give me. Keyboard, give it. Give me.
Give me that keyboard.
Give me that keyboard. Okay.
All right.
In my lap.
We're set.
I wonder why afternoons always make you feel sleepy like this. Me unspoke in a voice that went so far as to make whoever heard it lethargic. You want a medical explanation for sleepiness? I could say, but it'll just make you more sleepy. God, spare me. It was almost 3 o'clock. Sixth period was almost over. By the way, Satoko and everyone else in the lower grades ended their school day after fifth period, so they were probably running around in the schoolyard right now. I could hear their joy-filled voices coming from there right now. Oh, what I would give to be able to join them.
Mii-chan, you're the class representative, so you have to try harder. No going to sleep.
You see, rather than class representative, I'd rather be the president of the boxing club. They get to sleep a lot.
Huh? What makes you think that?
At the boxing gym, they're always hitting the sack. Get it?
Bam! Teacher cackled as she hit the back of Mio's head with the corner of a textbook. That's all for me. I'll leave it at that for today. Representative, please direct the class.
Everybody stand up! At attention!
Mion, who had been half asleep, became lively again at the moment she heard class was over. It must be delightful to be that shrewd.
Man.
Homeroom was done after the lower grades had finished their lessons, so we were free to go. It was one of the odd rules that we had in a mixed grade school.
When they knew class was over, Satoko and Rika-chan returned to the classroom. Good work today.
Turn the volume down. Music too loud.
Alright, it's time for happy fun club activities.
Satoko.
Yeah, that's right. What should we do today?
Hey, Rika-chan! Why don't we continue what we started yesterday?
Yes! We should do that! To have it end like that when things were getting good, I won't accept it! Now, I know how you feel, but let's save that for another time. Something like that shouldn't be done somewhere dinky like in a classroom after school, but a grander stage. I'm down whenever, but some of the younger guys said they'd watch me in the finals. So let me know ahead of time.
Whoa! Keiji-kun, you're amazing! There's people cheering you on!
I thought she was wondering, like...
Wow, Keiji, people actually like you?
I didn't know that!
I wonder if there's anybody cheering on Reina!
Can't help but watch as Reina enter her pining maiden vault mode. I'm not gonna pull any punches, but I'll pray for your victory, Reina. With a Sasharine. Keiichi brand smile, I ruffled Reina's hair roughly.
What? Oh. Keiichi-kun, what are you?
Reina turned bright red and short-circuited, smoke billowing from both her ears. Gazing to her eyes, a strange scene of me holding hands with Reina and skimming through a flower bed was reflected there. Ah. Even if it wasn't someone else's imagination, it was terribly troubling. Meet Keiichi, the Reina killer. When Rika-chan said that, everyone burst out laughing at once. That's Reina. That Reina is a Satoko and Rika-chan killer, though.
True.
Yeah. It may be true that we can't win against Reina, but we won't lose to Keiichi! Oh? This is becoming a pretty interesting relationship map. Our strengths kind of interact like rock, paper, scissors. But that doesn't include Mio, does it? Oh, that was Keiichi. Of course not. Doesn't matter who it is, I won't lose. Mio leered with a gaze befitting of the club president. No, befitting of an empress. The mood in the room became more lively. It was as good as a moment as any to get started. Well now, let's get started nice and easy.
Yeah!
Is there anything nice and easy with
them? So then,
Mi-chan,
what shall we do today? Today!
Sorry, didn't mean to talk while you were talking. That's okay, that was just me. I'm just sitting talking. Okay, you do that.
Mia let out a small interjection as she rummaged through the so-called club locker. Every time I look, there's always a ton of things crammed in there. Everything that's jammed in that locker is a game of some kind, you know? Mm-hmm. On top of that, things used for penalty games like cat ears and collars were kept in there. The capacity of that thing is unfathomable. That locker maybe it actually extended through the wall into the fourth dimension. That's my theory, anyways. If not that, then how else could you explain how someone could pull out item after item? After Mia touched her hand to her chin briefly and thought, she turned around without pulling out any games. Why don't we try and keep it a bit simple today? Playing games that require a lot of pieces all the time can be a little bland, right? Doesn't matter what game it is. If everybody plays together, we can have fun.
Yeah, that's right, that's right!
Ren and I both expressed our agreement. I feel the same way. With this group, there's no doubt even if we were pulling weeds from the school grounds, it would be fun. That wouldn't be fun for me. Pulling weeds or whatever. Ah, that's right, isn't it? By the way, Satoko, could you stop reading people's minds by looking at their expressions?
Whatever you're thinking is always written all over your face, so I always know right away.
I've always been told that, but ever since I transferred, it seems like it's been especially bad. I need to develop a poker face, or I could be in for a rough time. Alright, everybody, pay attention. I'm going to explain the rules. We all immediately cut the idle chatter and put on a stern expressions. In no time at all, everybody's gaze focused like a tiger or shark listening intently. That's right. To the point where the rules are explained, the match has already begun. Today's game is probably better known as a party game. It's called Sympathy. Has anybody heard of it before? Sympathy? It means to share someone's feelings, right? Huh. Maybe I might know this.
Me-chan, maybe it's the game where we choose a topic and everybody writes down the first word that comes to mind. And the more people who share the same answers, the more points are awarded. In that case, Rita knows about it.
I remember. I recall playing a game like that in grade school while we were on the bus during a field trip. I'm not familiar with this game. I would like an explanation. First of all, we have the leader choose a topic. For example, if they choose dessert. Sathka-chan, when someone says dessert, what's the first thing you think of?
Let's see here. Pudding or something.
Okay, in that case, Satko, you would write down pudding on your memo pad. Then everybody reveals their answers at the same time. If there's two or more people who wrote down pudding, they get points. The more people who write down the same answers, the more points are awarded. So if everybody writes down the same answer, that's a max of 5 points. In other words, the trick is to think so that what you write down is the same answer as everybody else. Which is exactly as Riki-chan said. The point of this game was to think in a way so that you have the same answer as everybody else. For example, even if you heard the word dessert and immediately thought of strawberry sundae, if your answer doesn't match up with everybody else, you don't get any points. That's why you have to hold off on that answer and change to one that seems like everybody else will choose. The key becomes not what you think yourself, but being able to predict what everybody else will answer. It's a very high-level intellectual game. Me, for Satsuko's sake, let's try practicing for one round. Okay, for this round, seeing as I'm club president, the leader will be me, alright? The topic can be something random. Taking out her literature textbook, she began flipping to a random page. Alright then, this is the only practice round. The first topic is shaved ice. When you say shaved ice, there's only one answer, isn't there? Among the standard flavors of shaved ice, there's strawberry, melon, and blue Hawaii. The most popular among those is obviously melon. Everybody write down an answer? Then everybody show theirs at the same time, okay? Ready? Go! Strawberry. Melon. Uchikin toki. Strawberry. What? I'm the only one with melon? You guys! Don't go do something so mundane as picking strawberry as the standard. Hey, Raina, would you actually order strawberry-shaped ice? The first thing that always sells out at summer festivals is always melon, isn't it?
Raina also likes melon flavor. But really, it's all about strawberry, right? Right?
Kei-chan, if I was to pick, I would actually choose melon. But you see, this is a word association game. If somebody says shaved ice, the first thing you think of is strawberry. So I'm still not entirely convinced, but in any case, it's this type of game.
Rika! What exactly did you write? Is that a type of shaved ice?
It's Ujikin Toki. It's incredibly delicious, you know?
Well, it might be delicious, sure, but it's not exactly run-of-the-mill. Still, that's a pretty refined choice.
Satsuko, did this help you get a good idea? There were three people who wrote down strawberry, so those people get 3 points. We compete to see who can get the most.
Yeah. I've got it. More importantly, Mion-san, what shall we do about today's penalty game?
Oh, there's gonna be one after all? What will it be?
What should it be? Kei-chan, do you have a suggestion?
What? For the penalty game? When I was in elementary school, there was a penalty game, yeah. Can only be that. Schlepping!
In other words,
That thing where the loser has to carry around everybody else's baggage happened often to them. Boys.
I think that's KG.
Elementary school kids walking around completely covered in backpacks. You see it a lot.
But how will we do that? Sonika-chan and Mika-chan's houses are the complete opposite direction from ours.
Then how about the loser carries just the winner's stuff to their house? Getting everybody's stuff to their house would involve covering a pretty sizable distance.
Oh yeah! Just that much? Might be alright!
Somehow, today's penalty game is pretty simple. With a penalty game of this level, wouldn't it even be fun to make Keiji-san do it? Then shall we raise the stakes a bit? Not just playing Porter. Ta-da! How about we have some schlep stuff around dressed in this? What? What a maid outfit of all things!
Oh no.
It's cute! It all put away!
But you see. What do we do if Keiji-san loses? If we don't have a size that fits him? Oh, I didn't let that little detail get by. I have a nice extra large size one prepared just for Keiji-san.
Get this plan.
So Keiji-san, are you ready? I'm gonna have you walk around outside dressed up as a maid. From the headband to the garter belt, even the underwear. I've got it all prepared for you. This is insane! Why do you have every possible size of that type of thing in that locker? This is bad, Keiji-mabara. Somehow, it's become a situation where only my failure results in an overly cruel price to pay. If I make a mistake, lose, I wouldn't be able to walk around in broad daylight anymore. Oh no, it's so gonna be bad for Keiji. Oh, ma'am, about the Marbara boy. Did you hear about him? Seems like he has a penchant for cross-dressing. Oh my, really? That'd be so embarrassing, you know?
Ooh. Oh man.
Yeah! I thought that's way too harsh! That's just incredibly brutal! If we're to return this penalty game to some semblance of normalcy, now is the only time! Everybody, I think we should refrain from this unwholesome penalty game. Why, on the way back home from school, do we have to be accompanied by a girl wearing a maid uniform and carrying our baggage? Having them sing Master while dragging them around the village in such an embarrassing outfit? Wait, why am I panicking? What is this? This feeling welling up inside me.
Hey, let's just make it a normal penalty game. Wait, Keiji-kun is frozen stiff.
Burning with passion, I firmly place my hands on Reyna's shoulders. Reyna, there is no problem with the penalty game. I just have to win. That's right, everybody. I turn to everybody with an idiotic grin, my pearly whites flashing with a brilliant gleam. Oh, Keiji-san, you've come around to the idea, eh? No matter what the penalty game is, there's no reason to be afraid. You just have to win. Right, everybody? Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yay!
From me on to Rika, everybody energetically thrusts their fists up high. Only Reyna seems somewhat undecided, standing there looking flustered. She's a little bit slow, isn't she? If she wins, even for Reyna, it's quite a delectable opportunity. Hey Reyna, don't you think this is a pretty big opportunity? Mika-chan or Satsuko in a maid outfit, coming right to your doorstep. This is a historically great chance, isn't it?
Oh.
Reyna begins spouting a fountain of blood from her nose. The look in her eyes completely changed. She shifted into cute mode. I was waiting for this, Reyna. That look in her eyes.
doorstep! It's not like Ichigo or Micho would be good too! Oh!
Alright! It looks like everybody's prepared themselves. Get your memo pads ready. First question, ready?
Mion opened her textbook to a random page and read out a word that caught her eye.
The first topic is summer break. This is yet another quite abstract keyword.
Well then, let's not worry about it too much and start with something like this.
Everybody good? Time to show them. Ready? Go!
On Mion's signal, everybody simultaneously held up what they wrote. Let's see, what did everybody write? Summer festival. Summer festival.
Fireworks.
Mosquito coils.
Oh, Rain and I have the same answer. Alright, 2 points.
But Satoko's fireworks are pretty good too. Rika's mosquito coils are very nice seasonal choice as well.
All the choices are quite invigorating. It's almost summer break, isn't it? I wonder how we'll spend it this year.
Invigorating words that evoke the image of summer break. Certainly things that enrich the soul. As everybody approaches the soon-to-come summer break, a plethora of dreams should be etched upon their thoughts.
By the way, Keiji-san, what did you answer? Hurry up and show us!
I didn't really write down anything that great.
No. Showing us is part of the rules. Now come on.
Stop it. Don't look.
Bikinis.
Homework. The room went silent. Nobody could really follow up that response. It's as if my impertinent answer had somehow sullied the wonderful dreams of the coming summer break.
Good summer breaks were never fun, were they?
It's alright. Let's spend the summer this year with everybody.
We won't leave you by your lonesome. Rika-chan gently patted my head.
What exactly did summer break mean to me?
Summer courses. Observing sunflowers. Practice exams. Special summer focus seminars. I know nothing of hot summers, because I've always been in an air-conditioned, cramped school. Ugh. The tears. They.
Keiji-san's summer breaks were always devoid of hopes and dreams, weren't they?
Don't look at me with such pity in your eyes! Don't look at me! Sorry, overacting.
Just a little bit.
There was a lot of ease. To be fair.
Should have changed pitch.
This game was called Sympathy. This game called Sympathy may be more terrifying than I could ever imagine.
Well, anywho. Ray and I get 2 points each. Let's keep going. Next is fish.
So it's fish. But think about it, I haven't eaten sushi in a while. By the way, rather than lean tuna, I'm quite the connoisseur on things like flounder. I wonder who I'll match with this answer. As for a Japanese person, anyone would think of this.
Alright, everybody.
This time we'll start from mine. Ready? Go! Sushi. How about that for an answer? When you see a lively fish, do you want to steam it or grill it? No. To have fresh sashimi is the epitome of cuisine. Or epitome. Rather than write sashimi, however, I chose the more amiable term in sushi. That is my cunning ploy. But, contrary to the intrepid resolve of my reply, everybody's expression was listless.
Oh, that's right! When you say fish! I see. Sushi is tasty, isn't it?
That reminded me of. Hey!
sound of innocence.
Stop talking to me in such a consoling... that consoling tone. Stop it! Well then, should the rest of us show our answers? Ready? Go!
Dolphin. Whale. Aquarium. Aquarium.
Rika and I have the same answer!
Oh no.
That's 2 points! Raina picked whale, eh? Thought about that too. But I ended up picking dolphin.
Oh, really? Raina wanted to write dolphins at first, but Raina didn't think anybody else would write it!
Either one of them is very cute.
Everybody, excluding me, stopped and stared blankly as their thoughts drifted over the horizon. It seemed as if they could hear the roar of the open sea from over there.
This means everybody has 2 points. Well, everybody but Keiji-san.
Keiji-kun's answers were worth 0 points. But Raina thinks they were very unique and interesting. Interesting!
To immediately think of food when you hear the word fish. Kei-chan, you should really be ashamed of how destitute your soul is, huh?
Come on. I cannot not do that now. Don't say my something like that. My soul is destitute!
Why? Seriously, why?
Dude, is he trying to sing? This boy is weird.
Besides, what's with Mion and Raina's answers anyways? Those aren't even fish! Those are mammals!
Objection overruled. Next.
What a horrid game this is today. As the games pile on and on, it seems as if I will be further exposed as a petty human being. I'm the only one who still hasn't earned any points. I want to at least get a point in the next round.
Well, you can't get one single point.
No. Alright, the next topic is Sakura. Damn it! This time I'll do it! Keep it cool, Cage Marabara. Don't think what you would normally think. Everybody else here is a girl. Stop thinking like a man. You want to write down Sakuramochi here, you'll be only repeating the tragedies of the past. Throw away that gastrocentric male sensibility. Just for now, think of yourself as a girl.
Oh god.
You are a girl. You are a girl. I'm a girl. Everybody finished writing? Let's do it. Keiji-san, if you don't start getting points right now, won't it be a bit dangerous? Huh. This time it's perfect. I've completely suppressed my own instincts. This time, I will have a match! No, I will make it match!
Keiji-kun, you seem pretty confident about this one. You see, this time, Raina felt like a boy so I could match up with your answer! Sakuramochi!
I like them too. I wrote it down.
Raina and Rika giggled together.
What? Now is not the time to think with your stomach!
Well then, did Keiji-san write the same answer as me? I put down Hanami. That's right! When you say Sakura, it just has to be Hanami, yeah? I wrote that down too!
Miyazato's responses was Hanami.
Hanami? Seriously? That's the kind of event where old geezers get drunk and do all sorts of depraved things. It's the standard, isn't it? Why of all times did you just decide to abandon answering from a girl's point of view?
Well then, Kei-chan, what sort of girly response did you write down?
It's nothing. Let's move on to the next topic. Moving on.
Before I knew it, Rika-chan had circled behind me and was intently reading the memo I had hidden behind my back.
Cardmaster Sakura is written down here.
Keiichi. It became dead quiet. The abrupt silence enveloped the room. It would be fine if somebody at least laughed at me or played it off as something dumb, but nobody even flinched. Feeling in the pit of my stomach reached critical mass, causing my once blood-drained face to flush with a sudden wave of heat.
Saka could only mean Cardmaster Sakura, can't it? It's a super popular anime that broadcasts every week on the government-run networks! It's broken through to every demographic from little girls to grown men! You've seen it, haven't you? No, you've definitely seen it! Even I've seen it!
Yeah. Even without the forced explanation, I know about it. It's that thing where she fights in a different costume every week, right? Yeah. I know.
Yep. It's cute, isn't it? Rina sometimes browses through a magazine stand to keep up with the story.
I saw it for the first time recently. Sakura is cool and cheerful all the time. I like that girl who always filming with the camcorder. It's not just popular with little girls. It's also surprisingly well received by older boys, isn't it? To think that K-chan was one of those. I felt like I'd inadvertently blurted out something that unnecessary and completely self-destructed, but that was the main problem. So you all know it, don't you? And why didn't you write it down?
Down.
Sakura means Sakura Kinomoto. Sakura-tan. Cardmaster Sakura is the right answer!
He's going crazy.
You can quietly put her head on my shoulder. Hand on my shoulder. K-chan. Now I am certain. K-chan, you are to your very core a geezer. Irrevocably so.
Why is everybody looking at me with those eyes filled with pity?
Pity! It reminds me of just JoJo.
Oh no!
The Joseph Joestar.
Oh no!
But that's not true, Keiichi-kun. Okay? Let's do our best. Here's where the comeback begins.
There's no comeback for Keiichi's on the geezer. Now give up and quietly accept your penalty.
What was today's penalty game again?
Dressing up as a maid, complete with hairband and garter belt while carrying around the winter stuff.
No!
Is that a JoJo reference?
Alright! If you're real members of this club, show me you won't let anybody come back from this disadvantage. Alright? Alright. Let's keep it rolling.
Man. They're just...
That's the end of the scene. Are we gonna find out who won?
I wanna know.
I wanna know if he can do it.
Is it possible for him to come back?
No. Not with this group. Oh no. We're outside.
Uh-oh.
Oh no.
Woo! Keiichi-kun seems happy! Why? How can this be?
He's probably awoken to the joys of cross-dressing. Oh no.
Oh, Keiichi-kun! Your hairband is gonna fall off! Let me fix that for you!
Rina cheerfully adjusted the hairband that had been enshrined upon my head. How does it feel, Kei-chan? Have you awoken to the pleasures of wearing girls' clothing in front of actual girls? Be honest now. It's alright. We won't laugh.
Arrgh! You jerk! I'm gonna murder you!
Swinging Mion's bag about wildly, I chased her in circles for a bit.
Today's loser was quickly decided to be me. When I had been assured of finishing last, Mion showed her true power. She began racking up points with an iron fist. In the end, we didn't even have to add up the score to know who was on top. After that, changing room. With much wailing and gnashing of teeth, pushing the boundaries of shame and brutality, I was instructed by Mion on how to put on everything from ribbons to underwear. Damn you, Mion! What do you mean knowing that? What do you mean knowing this will come in handy one day? How the bloody hell will a man know how to put on a garter belt be useful?
Shh! K-chan, you're too loud. If you stay quiet, you might be able to pass this off as a rehearsal for a play.
That's right! If I cause a scene here, then you'll find out that...
Oh, this is okay.
That's right. If I cause a scene here, they'll find out that I'm wearing women's clothing right down to the unmentionables.
How do you even read that?
I shuddered from head to toe, resisting the urge to scream.
Actually, K-chan, you have really smooth skin. Are you often told that it's easy to apply makeup on you?
Saying that, Mion gently rubbed my cheek.
Wah! What kind of man gets praised for being easy to apply makeup on them? Oh, no. How does it feel wearing a maid's hairband? It really finishes off the look. The hairband is the best part of the maid outfit after all.
What do you mean finishes off the look? Dumbass! Stop teasing me!
Keiji-kun is very cute!
That's right. Men like things like garter belts, right? So how does it feel wearing one yourself?
I don't really feel any...
Hey, stop it! Don't flip it up! It's tight, isn't it? Can you feel it rub against your skin as you walk?
Stop! Don't whisper such strange things in my ear! My miserable manhood's suddenly shifted. Eek!
You're turning red! You're turning red! Have you finally realized it? That's right. Right now, K-chan is exactly the type of maid that every healthy male wants.
Stop it, Mion! Really, why do you have to whisper that right in my ear?
Have you ever just wanted to hold a maid close to you? K-chan, you've currently become one with that maid. Don't you see? That's a distance far closer than mere touch can ever achieve. There. Can't you hear that pulse? That breath? On the verge of overheating, a long red line flowed out of Reina's nose. Putting on makeup properly, making you wear a wig with that straight long hair you like so much. K-chan, I've made you into your ideal woman. And now, you're gonna walk around town with me. You'll surely monopolize the eyes of all the men.
Oh, no.
That would definitely make you feel really good, wouldn't it? If only you didn't have to be that thing dangling... If only you didn't have this big thing dangling between your legs, you'd be a real girl.
Saying that, she tried to flip my skirt. Ah! This is definitely not the time! I can't let them see me with this male-centric problem. Crash that! Before I realized it, Rina was caressing my head and rubbing me with her cheek.
Keiji-kun, when you were fidgeting like that, you were super cute! I'm going to take you home!
Peering through Reina's vice-like embrace, I saw Mion laying spread eagle on her back. I see. This must be what Satoko and Rika-chan feel like when they become Reina's prey. After that, it took quite some time to calm Reina down from her frenzy.
Later, K-chan. Today was super enjoyable.
You will rue this day, Mion. This disgrace shall be returned tenfold! I shall achieve an overwhelming victory, then condemn you to a public shaming!
Only if you can beat me. I look forward to seeing you try.
Mio toss me my clothes.
Oh, hey, hey!
Okay. And looking at it as a good mood I've ever seen in life.
Hey!
Hey, what the fuck? Get over here! I wasn't done reading you! Ain't no speed reader! Okay, now. Now that I've been released by Mio, I can't waste even a second running home.
By the way, Rina isn't good as Mio-chan. So if we happen to bump into anybody, I won't be able to follow up for you, okay?
Soon after that, I went into a full-out dash. I'm pretty sure I was running the 100 meter in about 6 seconds there.
Well then, Keiji-kun, see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you tomorrow. The fact that I didn't bump into anybody and I knew was probably divine favor for my constant good behavior. It's been going my way today. At that moment, the front door opened as if someone was waiting for me. Oh, Keiji! So you're home. I was just about to go for a walk. I was dumbstruck by how slow my father was to react. No one person would have realized the peculiar scene before them around. Oh, Keiji. Dad. This is, you see, you know that club I'm always talking about? This is one of the penalty games we do there. It just so happened I lost today. My dad placed his hand on my shoulder. It's an oddly moist and uncomfortable warm hand. Keiji, I ain't such a fucking hand. Let's have a little talk in my studio. We'll keep it a mom. We'll keep it a secret from mom. Of course. No, Dad! Let go! There's a show I want to watch right now! You shall rue this day! His artistic flame raging like wildfire, my dad dragged me along. I disappeared into the depths of the studio.
Oh, no.
He's gonna have pictures of him.
He's gonna draw him! Oh, my God!
Keiji, are you home? Oh, you were in the bath. Was that makeup remover? But more importantly, what's the matter? Sorry, I have a headache and don't think I can make dinner tonight. I'm terribly sorry, but can you go out to eat with your dad? My mom is a go-get-em superwoman at work, but it occasionally takes a toll on her health. So this kind of situation is hardly a rarity. That's fine, but what will you eat? If it's just for myself, I could probably find a way to scrounge something together. Take care! Keiji! We'll take the car, so hurry up! Dad quickly got the car ready. He must be hungry. He really only moves so energetically when it's time to eat. Sorry to keep you waiting. So, where are we gonna eat? I recently found a nice store. Let's go there! My dad usually only complains about things. For him to actually praise something is unexpected. What kind of place it is that he rank it 3 stars? As one who seeks the way of the gourmand, I, Keiji Marabara, genuinely intrigued. The headlights of the car cut through the early darkness of the Hanamizawa night, carving a straight path towards town. I was pondering where such a gem of a restaurant could be hidden away. It was, shockingly, the family restaurant right by the station. Dad, that great restaurant you were talking about was this? The words Angel Mart were written on a very family restaurant-esque cartoonish logo. It had the air of a girl-oriented all-you-can-eat cake buffet rather than a proper restaurant. Never been inside Keiji Marabara? Come to think of it, I hadn't. There's been some times where I've traveled to faraway towns to eat, but returning only as far as Okunomiya Station, there was really no reason to dine out. Almost just a stone's throw away, after all. Let's see. That was the reason I'd never noticed it before. We stopped the car in the restaurant's parking lot. It seems like business is booming. There's quite a few cars parked here. What really amazes me are the license plates. There's a lot of them that can't be from this area.
Fukuyama Nagaya. Well, that's fine. Chiba? Saitama? Opening up my mental geography book, I calculated how long it would have taken to get here via the major highways. Keiichi, it seems that you finally realize how amazing this restaurant is. What's the meaning of this? How can so many people travel from so far away just to come to this restaurant? Calling my dad, I climbed the stairs and into the building.
I have a feeling we're gonna run into Mion.
I think so too. She has a lot of part-time jobs. The bell attached to the door clattered as we entered, and a waitress soon greeted us. After confirming our party size and whether we wanted a smoking or non-smoking seat, she guided us inside. Dad ordered two of the daily specials. It seemed that they were ready-made, so there wasn't much of a wait at all until our meals were brought to us. Taste was, no offense to Dad, not so different from a run-of-the-mill family restaurant. If you're just talking about the taste, it seems like normal family restaurant fare. Who gives a damn about the taste, Keiichi? See? Isn't it great? I see. It just may be that the food here might be nothing more than average. Demographic of the customers was pretty much all young men. It may call itself a family restaurant. There wasn't a single table with a family. Yet, it was packed. The parking lot was filled with cars from all corners of the country. They didn't come from far and wide to eat this completely mediocre food, then. There's only one other reason. Dad flagged down a nearby waitress. Excuse me, the dessert that comes out with the meal still hasn't come out yet.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
There's a dessert that comes with a daily combo A. I've been waiting for quite a while.
Oh, it's... My apologies, I'll bring it right away.
Is that Mio?
I think that was Mio. The apparently rookie waitress rushed off flustered. It's weird seeing Mio flustered. Dad, could it be this restaurant is... Aren't they great? Waitresses' uniforms here, I mean...
Wow.
What a creep.
Bam! What are you doing, Keiichi? Oh, father never hit me. I'm your son!
Listen, Keiichi. I've never come here with impure intentions. That ballet and iterante in eccentric clothing quel effect. It is my artistic muse. I want you to feel that. Even you must have yearned for this stimulation, haven't you? Coming here alone, though, is a bit embarrassing. You understand? That's why I've dragged you here. Just blame me. Even if you must condemn me, I wanted you to know this feeling, Keiichi. I need to take a leak. My father has always had a bit of a bad habit of trying to hide his embarrassment using incomprehensible nonsense as a smokescreen. I want to believe that this weirdness won't be a genetic. Continuing his one-sided rambling, my father stood up and headed to the washroom. With him gone, I was left alone in the booth. Finally, at this time, a feeling of embarrassment welled up inside me. I had nothing to do but go beet red with shame. The waitress from before returned, her eyes alternating between the order slip and the table. Arriving at my seat, she hesitantly tried to say something. A more veteran waitress offered some advice from over her shoulder. Just calm down and say, sorry for the wait.
Terribly sorry for the wait.
Oh no.
Right, just like that. Do your best. Whispering that into her ear, the veteran waitress left. This waitress must have just been hired. In absolute lack of confidence, she moved hesitantly and... maybe even somewhat perilously, just watching her put me on edge. I silently watched as she placed the dessert on the table with an inexperienced left hand. But it's just as Dad said, what incredible uniforms these are. What even are these uniforms?
That's Mion's sister.
Right! There's no possible way this could be Mion.
She would have recognized Keiichi.
Right!
Yeah, I was trying to fill that in my head. I'm like, why isn't she recognizing me? I remember she has a sister.
Yeah, in this one she has a sister.
Well, she's always had a sister.
Well, she just wasn't in the first one. For some reason.
They were like a bunny girl plus a maid plus some sort of frilly outfit.
I don't know what's...
perfect ratio. Most certainly a rather dubiously charming kind of fashion. In any case, she's in no way appeared to be a proper waitress. What should I do? I was catching glimpses of too many things. That is, I didn't know where I should look. Wearing something like that, walking around the restaurant, it's as bad as it can be for digestion. Even though she was wearing the outfit, this particular waitress had no idea what to do either. This flustered state, without a doubt, should be attributed to the amount of bare skin showing rather than being new to the job. Both the waitress and I mutually avoided eye contact. What a platonically embarrassing feeling this is. I'm a customer, you know? It's all right to be more straightforward. Oh, my nose is starting to bleed. At that moment, our eyes just appeared to meet. Both of us blinked, doubting who we were looking at. What? This is... Mio? Is that you? On top of her hair being let down, she was so far removed from usual confidence-filled attitude, I didn't realize it was her at all. It was Mio!
No.
Why is she here? You... Why are you working at a place like this? I'm helping out at my uncle's store. Come to think of it, I did hear her talk about how relatives have stores in town and that she sometimes works part-time to help them. Ooh! That must be a lot of work. The nervous feeling I had dissipated in an instant. Knowing that this was Mio, there was no reason to feel that way. Well, actually, my animal instincts tell me that the power balance between Mio and myself had been turned upside down. That's right, I'm a customer. My position is superior to hers. Humiliation from today's penalty game was cutting through the recesses of my mind. There really is a god. For him to grant me this opportunity for revenge. Uh-oh. Noticing the flames of vengeance burning in my eyes, Mio took a step back. But, seeing it like this type of clothing suits you very nicely, doesn't it? It's embarrassing, so don't look so much. I confirm my preemptive strike was a clean hit.
Maybe it is Mio.
There's no mistaking that Mio is currently defenseless. While confirming my attack was successful, I simultaneously lined up the combo. Mion, you have pretty big breasts. It seems like they're ready to spill out even right now. All the customers are definitely looking at you. Don't say that. Don't play coy with me. I know that you enjoy drawing all the male attention with that embarrassing getup. I mean, if you didn't, there's no way you'd dress up like that. It's not like that. I'm doing this because I like to. I'm sorry, my brain just went dead. Is this alright? Keichimaru. My brain wants to say it's her talking, but it's himself in his head. Is this alright, Keichimaru? Aren't you taking this a little too far? Even if it's payback for that humiliation during the day, isn't this too much? Hey, shut up, Logic! To pay back Mio tenfold is a chance you hardly ever get! Wearing this kind of getup, your mother must be disappointed. That part where you can almost just see something is the best. Come closer! Please stop! You still lack the spirit of service towards your customers. Please forgive me. I want to take you home. Please, easy. No, not that! Entering a version of Raina's cute mode, blood spewing from my nose like a waterfall, I was going until I had no regrets. I was going to complete this verbal humiliation revenge for today's events. Yep. I'll spare you the rest for today. Seems that Mion's neural circuits had completely shorted from the embarrassment. might have teased her a little too much, or so I thought, but such a meek Mion is something you hardly ever see. So this was good for now. Leaving aside what exactly was good. I never knew to think that the high and mighty Mion would have a hard time being a waitress.
That's wrong. That's wrong.
This is such a surprising side of you. I want to show this to the Mion from this afternoon. Actually, I want to show Reyna and the others. Reyna will definitely flip out with joy. Do you think she'll say she wants to work here?
That's wrong.
I can never imagine in my wildest dream that such a cute outfit would suit you, Mion.
I'm saying that's wrong.
Well, turning bright red, Mion finally spit out the words that were lodged in her throat. What do you mean? That's wrong.
I'm not Mion.
What? I was taken aback at Mion's confusing words. If you're not Mion, then who are you? You're Mion Sonozaki, right?
I'm sorry. I should have said this earlier, but my name is Shion Sonozaki.
I knew it!
Mion is my older sister.
My eyes unconsciously widened with surprise from this brazenly crazy talk. Mion, probably thinking that there was no way for such a far-fetched excuse would work, turned bright red while fidgeting nervously. Shion? Shion Sonozaki?
Yes. I'm often mistaken for my sister. But when we met, you had the kind of response that you wouldn't make if you were meeting for the first time. That's because my sister is always talking about you, so I knew who you were.
A little bit of cringeworthy excuse, that is. But when I looked at Mion's eyes, which begged me to believe her, the urge to tease completely subsided. To us, Mion had to be a leader who was normally overflowing with confidence, a guiding force. If I were to lash out at that Mion, I would have ruined something I shouldn't have. That was something I would never wish for. So I understand. This foolishness here is something very different from the everyday Mion. That's why she's Shion. I see. In that case, I'm sorry.
Oh no, it's as long as you understand. My sister has a lot of enemies, you see.
Well now, she's self-aware of that fact that she... In fact, now is she... As I unintentionally laughed aloud, Shion laughed with me. Shion, is this your first time being a waitress? It doesn't seem like you're used to it.
Actually, today is, Kei-chan is my first customer.
A little flustered after saying that, she quickly asked if it was okay for her to refer to me as the same way her sister did. Seeing that blatant quirk was so cute, I couldn't stop laughing. So, you said you worked part-time at your uncle's store before. I thought you would have been more used to it.
Oh, I have other relatives that run shops. That's why this is the first time I'm helping the uncle that owns this place.
I see. Makes sense. Anybody would be tentative doing a job they weren't used to. Does Mion ever hop out of the store?
Oh, my sister is... You see, she's not good with these cutesy things.
I know what she's trying to say.
That's right. Mion is more suited for cool things. So I think
having you help out here was the right choice.
Huh?
Shion asked, probably thinking she misheard me. That uniform, it would never suit somebody like Mion, but for Shion, I think it works.
Huh? You mean that?
Shion, like Reyna often does, spaced out and turned bright red.
What does that mean exactly?
At least for this moment, it felt like this Shion character actually existed, because there was no way that the Mion I knew had this side to her. That moment, we realized that the more veteran waitress was waving at us from across the room.
Sonozaki-san! You can take a break now! Oh, okay!
Mion finally returned to her senses. It seemed as if it was time for her to take a break.
Well then, I'll take my leave. It was fun talking to the infamous Kei-chan.
Sorry for mistaking you for Mion and teasing you. Please tell Mion that I will have my revenge one day.
Ah,
that thing you were forced to dress as a maid and walk around outside, right? A devilish laugh and smile was exactly the same as the one I knew. That's right. Tell her that I will return the favor for the total humiliation I suffered.
Bleh.
More importantly, I'm going to complain to my sister about the teasing I had to endure today. My sister will have my revenge during club activities.
Oh, no.
Bring it on. I'll get her before she gets me. Mio laughed with a warm smile, devoid of any remaining nervousness, and disappeared.
It's confusing because he keeps saying Mion. Stop saying Mion, it's Shion.
I felt like I had a very valuable experience today. That's right, from now I know High Mighty Mion has a weak point to panic and get embarrassed about. But of all things for her to say, she has a twin sister. I thought maybe I should ask Raina tomorrow if she really has a sister.
He still thinks that it's Mion. He thinks it's all a ploy, and Mion is just, like, defense mechanism. Oh, I'm her sister!
Cheon!
I didn't just come up with that name.
I'm not Mion! I'm Cheon!
Maybe it's better that I didn't ask. It's a bit mean-spirited. I've decided that the person I met here today was Cheon, the younger twin sister, so I'll refrain from doing anything that would deny that. It's not that we actually made a promise or anything, but that little exchange gave birth to a new rule between me and Mion. Somebody tapped me on the shoulder. My dad. That was long trip to the washroom.
What? That's not English. That's not English. No.
Maybe they translated it, Blake.
It's bad English.
That was long trip to washroom.
To the washroom.
Go, I had to.
That was a long trip to the washroom.
He probably came up with a new idea for the art piece when he was sitting on the can. Keiichi, are you about ready? Let's go home. Settling the bill, my father had his customer card stamped. It was pretty much filled. Damn, Dad, you're quite the regular customer. Was that new waitress just now somebody you knew? You know, Keiichi? Oh, so you were watching from the shadows. Dad had the oddest sense of tact sometimes. Somebody from school? From Minamizawa? Yeah, she's the little sister of my friend Mia. School isn't in Amizawa, so she must go to one in town. I've never seen her at my school. Huh, so not all the kids in Amizawa go to the same school. Only about half. The other half go all the way into town on their bikes. In this way, the feeling that I was really talking to Shion came to me. What should I say to Mion tomorrow? I met your little sister. Something like that? Even with Mion being like that, us having a secret between the two of us being both a little happy and a little embarrassed.
Oh man, today's long.
Yeah.
Blake sips from his water. He is refreshed.
Slightly.
Ready to go on.
Still a little faint in the throat.
Hey!
Hey, he's
really Shion.
Look at the thing that nobody else can see!
Why can't they see it?
I don't know. It's weird. OBS doesn't capture the achievement. It's super weird.
Stupid.
Voodoo tips!
Oh, we got two today.
We got two tips. Okay, this is an extra long episode today, but they're all long!
2 hours.
Can you really blame us?
2 hours. Longest episode ever.
I'm constantly reminded of how good these backgrounds looked. Remember how shit they were?
Dude, I wasn't looking.
Oh, God.
I forgot to look.
I was too invested.
Same. Damn it. We need to go back through and...
Huh? Mio-san's family?
Yeah. More broadly, I was just wondering if she had any brothers or anything. I was actually wondering whether her younger twin sister named Shion actually existed. My curiosity got the better of me, so I quietly asked Satoko about it.
I wonder. She might. She might not.
She wasn't being very clear about it. Had Satoko never gone over to Mion's house to play? From your reaction, I guess you've never met any?
Yes. I've never seen any of her relatives except for her grandmother.
As far as I could tell, there were already dark clouds over the Shion is real theory. Rika would know more than I.
You would do well to ask her.
Satsuko waved to Rika-chan, who was basking in the sunlight.
Rika, do you know anything about Mion-san's family?
Rika-chan was surprised at the sudden question.
He has a big family, so I don't really know everything about them.
That many, huh? For example, is there someone named Shion Sanazaki? Well, I might have heard wrong, so she might not actually exist, but...
I mean, she? Shion exists.
Huh? That was unexpected. So she was real!
Huh? Their names are quite similar, you know. I could get tongue-tied trying to tell the difference. I've heard she's Mii's younger twin sister, but I haven't met her too many times.
Rika-chan knew a bit about her as well, but hadn't seen her much.
I think I met her once at a funeral a few years ago. She's not in this class, so maybe she goes to a school in Okinomiya. She may live there too. Mio-san herself lives apart from her family with their grandmother, after all.
She didn't live with her parents? That was a bit odd. Was there something between them?
It's a very complicated family. She seems to have many relatives. There are doubtless many circumstances.
For now, I learned that she had a younger twin sister named Shion, but her family structure, including her own position, still seemed very mysterious.
Oh? What are the three of you talking about? Let this old man in on it. Oh, Mion-san! You've come at a good time! Might it be true that you have a younger twin sister? Ah, Mio. Crap. A younger sister?
Whoa!
Whoa!
Whoa! Is she like turning?
She's phasing out of existence?
Wait, no.
I think she's turning towards Satoko. I think that's what it was implying.
Or she backed up.
A younger sister. Well, yeah, look at that time. Gotta go. I do.
The young girl uncharacteristically red in the face, at a loss. I think she's looking at me.
Oh my. I had no idea. What kind of person might she be? I would very much like to meet her sometime.
She's back.
You shouldn't bother. She's not cute at all. She's really conceited. Besides, other than talking to her on the phone once in a while, I haven't seen her for a long time either.
What? Why did it look like she was in such a panic?
What? Why?
Is James modifying the text? It couldn't be possible.
Why did it
look like she was in such a panic?
Why did it look like she's in
It's as if declaring she that she from yesterday was fake, actually. Anyway, this was pretty funny, so I let it go for a little while longer. Another Mion under the name of Shion. Will I be able to see if I go to that restaurant again? I had a mysterious feeling as if I had made a new friend despite knowing that she and Mion were the same person.
Oh my gosh.
Why does it look like she's... What grief.
James can't modify the text, can he?
No. I think that's just bad translation.
Why does... It looks like...
And they were like back to back, practically, the two instances of bad translation.
Reprinted from the Victorious War Photographer's Guide, April issue. Complete Conquest Analysis. Family Restaurant Chapter. Now at last, we've come to the blazing hot third day. To Angel Mort, a super famous restaurant and the envy of all enthusiasts, despite being located in the remote Shishibone City at XX Prefecture. Why exactly do the most famous stores avoid the centers of human habitation? It can only be because of the trial given to us by the god of war photography. It's famous locally for having the best desserts in town, but that matters not to us. If you want expensive dessert, then you can just go to a censored place or something.
Censored.
We aim not for sweet treats, but for sweet uniforms. The fragrant aroma of Sweat wafts from these obligatory waitress uniforms, creating no less than a public torture device. How could their bashful flirtation be on par with the other restaurants with cute uniforms all across the country? War photography hunter, away!
So confused.
The smoking areas are the real superpositions. Aim for your chance at them with the tenacity of an octopus. Yesterday I failed to get a seating. Today I will aim for the ultimate golden seat, the corner box in the smoking area. Otaku are overwhelmingly non-smokers, so I'll procure a spot in the smoking area and set up camp there. As expected of Ryu, the hunter. He's saying his victory was decided the moment he chose his seat. In actuality, Ryu used the same tactic during the grand opening of Akihabara's and succeeded in getting the best seats in the house. Back then, he also went early into the afternoon just after the lunch rush, and only did he find his target seat empty. He also obtained it for ease. But utilizing tricks such as ordering a little at a time, he effectively increased the number of opportunities for engagement, carefully scoping out his chance for a picture. But, as if cursed by that, from the day before, the god of war photography did not smile upon him. After suffering successive firm defeats until 3 p.m., he found no chances coming his way. At 4 p.m., a man began to take his orders. It looks as though he has been seen through. It is the rule of a hunter to withdraw with grace once marked. My aim was perfect, but the fork technique I used at 2:30 seemed to have backfired. Maybe they were wary since I sat in a booth and left my bag on the floor. My camera was already hidden in my travel bag and might fossilize in there. There were two-digit EGs involved for sticking here half the day. I have a high encounter rate. Mortified. Even so, I still got a few pieces of gold. As to be expected from the hunter. He attained his nice angle despite lamenting his failure. He's an artisan. What surprised me though is that this uniform conquest across Japan has yielded not a single arrested person. An amazing start for the hunter who brags about having been to approximately half the total prefectural police stations in the country. That thing that the day before. The day before, our hunter took on the Shrine Man and Cuisine in Nagoya. His hunter spirit showed through too zealously, and as soon as he entered the store, he was seen through, placed in a booth, and waited on by the head priest. Despite waiting half a day, the much-anticipated shrine maid had appeared only at the time of his first order. A seriously huge blunder for a hunter. Now then, here we have a giveaway of the hunter's original photographs that have already received such high praise. We'll present one passionate reader with three all-you-can-eat, low-angle pictures of the Angel Mort uniforms chosen by the hunter himself. With such blazing hot pictures, you too!
What? You clicked it twice.
I did not!
You did.
Bullshit. You too.
Again,
read.
Pause. Pause it. Right. Pause it there.
All right, that's where everyone's going to be pausing. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed. We will see you in the next video. Shion confirmed.
Wait, she's not confirmed yet.
I confirm her.
I don't.
I confirm her as a cutie.
Yeah, she's a cutie.
Alright, we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.